Hi friends, my name is Augustine Asiedude, and the purpose of this video is to introduce to you university programs and career opportunities we have in the various university programs. So today we are going to look at one of them, of which when you pursue is surely going to grant you a job. But one thing I always tell my viewers is that we choose program based on our interests or based on what we think we can do well. So you choose program based on the career you want to pursue. So today we are going to look at Bachelor of Science in Business Administration, of which banking and finance is going to be your major, or is going to be your area of specialization. So if you are thinking of pursuing a business degree, of which banking and finance is the area you want to specialize, then this is a place you can understand it better, and then you also know some of the various career opportunities you can pursue after pursuing Bachelor of Science in Business Administration, Banking and Finance as your area of specialization. So when you pursue this program, you have a lot of programs, but basically when you are doing business administration, the first 2 years, or let's say the first year, you normally have a common courses to offer. But when you get to level 300 or the third year, then you specialize at the area you want to go. So when you are in level 100 and level 2, you do something like language skills, critical thinking, introduction in business administration, introduction in public administration, and other stuff. So when you get to level 300 or third year, that's when you specialize. That's when you focus on where you want to go exactly. So when you get as banking and finance expertise, or trying to be an expert over there, this is what some of the program that I do. You do business finance. Business finance deals with how you raise capital for your business or your organization or whatever you are doing, and how you can also mobilize funds for operation or expansion, or when your business is crashed down, or when you are losing financial capability or capacity, how you mobilize, how you sort funds to finance the business to get back on feet. I hope you understand. You also do something like monetary theory, how money is being circulated in the country, or how money should be provided. All these things are done by these people who have knowledge on monetary theory, so that we can know how much we should provide, or how much money should be provided or be given into the system, or should be supplied into the system. That's the correct term they use for it. So the interest rates of money, how people are buying, how people are selling and do stuff. So monetary theory gives you all the knowledge or the tools to evaluate or calculate all these things, and then you give financial advice to the country or to the government, so that way they can make proper decision on how much they should supply into the system. You also do something like bank management, just with how you can manage the bank here particularly, or any financial institution. I'm not talking about banks alone, but bank alone will give you all the knowledge to manage financial institutions. You also do something like investment fundamentals. Yes, how your company or your business, or you particularly, or how you can give somebody a consultation or advice on investment. Investment fundamentals is going to help you, and it's going to give you all the necessary knowledge on proper investments, because people are investing their monies in organizations and business that at the end they normally lose their money. So when you get all these things, you can give advice, or you can give training or understanding to people before they start investing. You also do financial markets, or financial marketing. This with forex, this with stock, this with bond. But let me talk of stock exchange and other stuff. So this is how some business share or sell stocks. So you as a financial or banking and finance expert or student or whatsoever you call yourself, you have to give people the knowledge on what to sell or what to buy at the stock exchange or at the stock market. So when you have this thing, you can even become a broker. I hope you understand, so that you can give people the advice, or you can buy for people at a percentage of which they are going to pay you, right? Okay. You can also help people to understand the currency, the how currency is exchanged. Yeah. And you know, a typical example is Ghana and US dollars. Yeah. Now $1 is equivalent to 5 cedis 80 pesos or so, or 8.2. So you are going to tell the people how they should change, or the amount of money will be equivalent to the foreign country's money. Yeah, if they want to buy something, or if they want to do business, or somebody wants to go for advance or holidays, or let's say education, and then you are looking at the tuition fee, you have to convert it for the people so that they can understand it better, and then they can do it and have their business or have their education up, going up there. All right. So I won't talk much of the programs, but I think I've given you about 6 programs or so. So when you do such a program, you have a lot of business opportunities. But somebody may ask, what are the people who qualify for this program? If you're in Ghana and you're a business student, automatically you qualify. And then school or university, like King University, is also accepting general students, those who have either elective maths or economics. Yeah, but when you have elective maths and economics particularly, then you are easily going to be admitted, or you have the chance to be admitted. Even University of Ghana is also doing the same. And then if you're also a science student, because of your elective maths, you have the opportunity to pursue this program. So business, science, general arts, provided you have elective maths and economics, you have the chance to pursue this program, and then you have your way through. And then let's talk of some of the job opportunities you can have. You can become a broker, like I said earlier, who helps people to sell shares, or who help people to buy stocks. Okay. You can also become a bank manager. Yeah, all the managerial work at the bank, you can become one. And then, but don't be fooled or don't be lied to, because when you start, probably the best place you can ever be is the personal assistant to the bank manager. So you don't expect to push. However, if your father or your uncle or whatever, if your relative is having a bank and you are going to take the position, I'm cool. We are cool. So we expect them. You can also become investment analyst or consultant. If people want to invest in any particular business, they can consult you, and you can do the analysis for them to understand it before they enter. So you can become investment analyst and consultants. You can also work at the forest companies or organizations, of which money is exchanged. So you can also work at those places, and a lot of financial institutions will be employing you. So if you want to work in any financial institution, you can also establish your financial institution. It's not something big, just establish something small that will bring financial solutions to people, whether working multi-credit or cooperative or what's your bank, rural banks and other stuff. If you have this knowledge, you can bring solution to some problems, to people, to customers, to even the organization or the bank itself. So if you pursue this program, brethren, I expect you to solve problem, especially financial crisis or financial problem, so that seeking job or doing job is not going to be a problem for you. And if you have a problem solving mentality, trust me, finding job is going to be easy for you. So friends, I won't take much of your time, but if you want to pursue a program in business administration, of which banking and finance is going to be your area of specialization, I think this information will help you, and then you push forward. Thank you.